It's time for Hoochie Coochie. It's time for Hoochie Coochie. Time for Hoochie Coochie. Time for Hoochie Coochie.
She's up to all kinds of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Voila.
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 She's very, very continental, that Gloria.
Yes, voila, oui. Oui, je t'aime, ça, c'est la vie.
You were just frisky.
Mm-hmm. Frisky. Totally frisky. I'm frisked out.
Are you like eating lots of blueberries or something? Like,
actually, I have been eating berries, and I never did before.
Because you know,
could that be it?
Berries make you frisky.
I didn't know that.
Yes.
See? Explanation.
Yes.
There you go.
Gloria Estefan with us here on the Morning Jolt. I'm Larry Flick with Keith Price. We have Emilio Estefan as well. Now, Gloria is our OutQ icon for the month of October. She'll be the subject of iconography. Coming soon this month, and she'll be the voice of our channel for the entire month. And we had a really great conversation when I flew to Miami to visit with her at the legendary Crescent Moon
Studios. With the creaky table.
And it was like, here, let me take you behind the scenes of our day together. First of all, I have to find out, did Emily get grounded that day?
Grounded?
Why because remember, grounded? Remember, you were like, I have not heard from Emily.
I know, she didn't get grounded, of course.
No. You were annoyed, though.
No, I was just worried, not annoyed. I was worried. Listen,
she
child
annoyed.
Cannot know. She was still in school. That's why I hadn't heard from her. She had to stay after she was in the jazz band thing. Look, that child has never annoyed me in my entire life.
Really?
Ever, ever, ever. Other one, on the other hand.
Naive. How you doing?
He was a handful. But Sid's so lovable and great kid, but he was just mischievous, just like his daddy.
Well, he used to come on the road with you guys, right? And
always,
wreak havoc.
Always, always.
Tell me about it.
The stories of Naive on the road were legendary.
Oh, legendary. And I've only been finding out recently. I go, you know what, Naive, I really don't want to know. Too much information.
Too much information.
I want to still love you.
He was 9 years old. And I get a call from the front desk in Paris. He was trying to buy Playboy.
He was six
and
at
charge
the time.
It to the room. So imagine that being nine years old.
Oh, my
Lord. In Holland.
Wow.
In Paris.
I believe it. All right. I believe it. I believe it.
Just like Emilio, that one. He's mischievous. Mischief.
I love life.
Yeah, he does.
Yes,
he loves scaring people. He loves his favorite thing to do is wait until I'm naked about to go in the shower. Ooh. And scare me somehow. He comes up behind me. He sneaks up. And then he goes, what do you want me to do? Put a chain? Wear bells? I go, you did it on purpose. You could at least say, hey, baby. What? He does it on purpose.
He does it on purpose.
Yes, he does.
I'm going to have to get a boombox.
Keeps it interesting.
You know,
But now this is, when people ask the question about what makes a great marriage, it's like just that alone tells me how much fun.
You have to laugh.
We laugh. Just being able to have that kind of
Listen,
all
the
time.
Big problem is like, I love Lucy, but I'm Lucy. That's the problem.
Exactly.
Really?
He's the troublemaker.
You know what? I believe that.
He's the troublemaker.
I believe that because Gloria, that's why I'm finding this album so jolting. because this is frisky Gloria.
Yes.
And Gloria, I know, the Gloria I know for over 20 years is the Gloria who is like reasonable.
I'm still reasonable. I'm
but now
totally
you're saucy.
Still reasonable.
But he's the one who's always up to trouble. Whenever I go to Miami, it's always like, Gloria is resting, or Gloria's in vocal, or Gloria's pregnant. And Emilio's like, let's go to Bongo. We were talking during the song, and I'm like, you know, we need to get together and do a party. He goes, yeah, let's go to Bongo.
Because I know you like to party. I know
exactly
how you are. You're talking about me?
Well, yes, we have had some fun together. We have. Yes, you're big.
You got to have fun in life. You got to have fun. You got to enjoy every minute. We laugh all the time. You got to laugh.
Listen, you never know when things are going to change.
Yes,
and if you know something, you have to take that. It's the last day you're going to live in your life. And that's the way I live. I mean, after the accident, our life changed.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we was on top of the world with the press in the United States, you know, sold out tour, and everything changed. And, you know, that even when I was a kid, leaving Cuba was so hard for me. I learned so many things. And then, you know, we realized the American dream. And then the whole thing happened with the accident. And that proved you that, you know, your life can change in a minute. So after that, every time I want to say I love to kiss anybody, I do that. If I want to buy something, I buy it. If I want to do something, I do it, because you never know, so the next day it won't happen. So might as well, people should learn to, you know, appreciate life a little bit more. And lose less time about, you know, the, you know, bad things in life.
Yeah,
and that's why medicine talks about that. You live life. You got
to
live life.
And it's funny because I was listening to medicine, and then this morning on my way to work, I was listening to my all-time favorite record of yours. You know what record it is, right?
Which one is that?